previously. We migrated Bulk Candy Store to BigCommerce, which has led to a significant improvement in their conversion rates. A big part of that improvement, along with our plan to continue their growth, was developing a pop-up strategy. In this episode, we'll show you how pop-ups are leveraged to aid those conversion rates, add more potential customers to their email list, and how it gives them the ability to better merchandise high-margin products to increase their average order value. This is the e-commerce makeover. No one likes the idea of pop-ups, but you can't argue with the results when they're done well. They can be an invaluable tool that has a direct impact on some of an e-commerce business's most important metrics. Let's see what Ken is looking to be able to do so that we can find the right tools to make it easy for him.
How many subscribers are you adding to your newsletter each month?
Maybe 300-400 a month. I think if we were a little more aggressive about it, we could get more. I think pop-ups would be very successful for us because I think that if you want to advertise something, it's best to be in somebody's face. Pop-ups are one of those things that when they first came out years ago, everybody overutilized them. I think as time has gone on and people have started to use them strategically, they've become better. I notice now more and more sites are using them to collect email. If you do a pop-up and say, hey, I'm going to give you something special if you give me your email, I think that's wonderful. I think people appreciate that. If you're just popping up things all the time, it's a problem.
Have you ever looked at exit offers or really trying to recapture that traffic that's leaving without buying?
I've heard of that, I've seen that, but we've never tried it. I don't know how to do that, but I'd love to be able to look at that.
Are there any other things that you're excited about trying or you really want to try once you have a good pop-up management tool?
I'd like to present the right offer, if you will, at the right time. If there's a product that we're focusing on or that we really want to sell, or it's new, it's exciting, it's innovative, and there's really no great way to alert them, hey, guess what, we have this product coming out now. But when we started doing freeze-dried products and they became all the rage, we didn't have a way to push that to people unless they were either on our email list or they happened to hit the homepage and see the banner that says freeze-dried. I'd like a way to be able to hit every customer who comes in and go, hey, try our freeze-dried stuff or try our giant peanut butter cups or something that's unique.
Ken is excited about the possibilities, but rightfully concerned about pop-ups. Those concerns stem from not having the right tools to even execute a proper pop-up strategy. Before we show him how to overcome those concerns, if you want to learn more about how we're helping Bulk Candy Store, go to ecommercemakeover.com and download our playbook on everything we're doing, including special offers on all the tools we'll be using, and subscribe to be notified each time we release new episodes. Let's fix Ken's pop-up issues once and for all. He's going to love Justuno, so let's learn more about how they can help Bulk Candy Store.
My name is Steph Carcamo, and I work with Justuno. At Justuno, our focus is conversion rate optimization.
How are you today, Ken?
Good, how are you?
I'm great. It's great to meet you. Today, I really want to get to know more about what your ultimate goals are. Are there any main priorities that you have with launching the site?
There are a couple of things that we want to do. We want to obviously get as many customers as we can, but we also want to take advantage of the customers we have. The conversion rate right now for the site we're on is not terrific. We're hoping that we can increase that.
And do you have some solid channels that you're already established in terms of communicating with these visitors?
We do email right now. With the move, we're hoping to improve that as well. We're moving from MailChimp into Klaviyo. And we're taking advantage of a lot of the things that Klaviyo has to offer.
I think a great use of pop-ups is for email signups. We used pop-ups for a little bit, but because we couldn't control them very well, I shied away from it. And it would show up 5 or 6 times and people would call and say, it's getting annoying, this thing won't go away.
With pop-ups, I think a lot of the conversation before has been that it's a nuisance and it's just because at times it's not done quite right. We do want to stick with best practices. We want to make sure we're not burdening the visitor with too many pop-ups in that visit and that they're not seeing double pop-ups in one page.
How do you feel like you're going to communicate with your visitors on site?
One of the changes that we've made from the existing site that we're going to the new one is it's going to be a lot more playful. Fonts are a little more interesting. The colors are brighter.
That'll really help us out in the pop-up messaging world. You know, the more playful we can be, that's ideally going to lead to higher engagement. From our perspective at Justuno, we like to target a few touch points that we see as that foundational approach to pop-ups or messaging. So we're looking at a welcome offer. So whether it's an email capture, letting them know what to expect or getting them into that newsletter flow, an exit offer, So we're targeting that visitor that's just about to leave your site, and a sweet deal could really make it or break it for them, to really target that conversion rate that's a goal for you, and at least get a baseline for what we can test later on.
The importance of having an exit offer on your website is to give those visitors that intend to leave incentive to remain on your site and complete that purchase. It could be in the form of an offer or a unique message.
Any kind of like mystery gifts or gift with purchase offers that you do a lot of depending on your stock?
We have not done a lot of them yet, but we started a bit last year and it worked very well. We started adding a gift of popcorn with every order.
Ooh, okay.
We would include a bag of rainbow popcorn, and it did bring up some of the popcorn sales, so we're looking to do more of that.
That would totally get me if I had that. And those are cases where, let's say, you know, you're sending out those offers and we know a visitor purchased XYZ product. The next time they're on site, we can target them based on knowing that they purchased that product and provide that upsell or cross sell on that next visit, or just provide another offer or maybe incentive to gift it depending on the season.
That's great. I mean, wonderful.
Product recommendations are really great for a visitor, whether they're new or returning. Within Justuno, you have the ability to place one of these recommendations so that it looks like it lives within your website and doesn't necessarily have to be a pop-up.
SMS capture, is that something that is new to your team? Are we still in the exploring stage?
We're still exploring. We haven't done SMS yet. I know that Klaviyo, our email provider, does it, so we're gonna look into it after we transition.
SMS is important because a lot of visitors are going to be on their phone. Whether they're checking their text messages or actually visiting your site on their phone, it's an important device that's always ready for them. SMS should be considered its own channel. The messaging is a little shorter, and it's a way for visitors to get to their offers quickly.
Have you done any brainstorming on how you want to position that channel or what you really want to use it for?
None whatsoever, so any advice you have would be greatly appreciated.
Yeah, sky is the limit on that. You know, it's such a new channel. It's kind of like you can mess it up a little bit as you're testing and really feel it out with your visitors. But for the most part, it's figuring out what kind of info your visitors want from there. Maybe it's more just that shipping information that you're sending, or you're giving more of that new product updates or back in stock information. It's a great channel to be more conversational a lot of the time there and feel like you're connecting with your customers.
Justuno is another simple install. After installing the app from the marketplace, we just needed to go in and design the promos, decide the targeting rules that would trigger when the promos are offered to customers, create the coupons of BigCommerce, and then upload those to Justuno. We then set the promos live and awaited the results. We'll find out the longer term results later in this series, but let's check with Ken to see how it's going so far.
So how have your first pop-ups performed?
Much better than I expected. When you hit the site for the first time, you're gonna get a spin to win function. And once you spin or put in your email, we capture your email, you get a coupon. I see a lot of those coupons coming in.
So how many email signups are you getting now?
We're getting substantially more than before because now almost everyone who comes in is signing up for the emails. We're probably doubling our numbers from before.
What about the exit intent?
As you're about to leave the site, it's gonna pop up and say, hey, you wanna get a little special offer if you're gonna leave? I'm seeing 4 or 5 a day at least, which means that's 4 and 5 orders that I probably wouldn't have had otherwise. That automatically brings your conversion rate up, brings your revenue up, so I'm real happy with them. The software itself is great. The team to work with, they have been very, very helpful. They have a conversion rate specialist who works with you right at the beginning, helps you set it up, helps you get it figured out, and probably the part that most impressed me was, in addition to the pop-ups, I'm able to go in and set up. I wanted to put a banner to advertise something, and I wanted it on the whole site, not a pop-up on this page or that page. I wanted it on the whole site. I was able to place a banner up on the top of the site in literally 4 minutes. And the software is very easy to use. I'm real happy with it.
A lot of people are concerned about pop-ups and, you know, having a negative user experience. Have you seen any negative impacts from the pop-ups?
I've gotten no negative feedback so far. I'm very conscious of that. That's why we're trying to be very strategic in the use of them. If you've already seen this pop-up, I don't want you to see it again. In addition, these are nice looking. They have a reason to be there. That they add value.
Right now you're doing the basics when it comes to pop-ups, but you've got the tool. So what things are you excited about trying with Justuno?
I'm mostly excited about trying to push things that we're trying to push at the right time. So really getting specific with it. So when someone's going to buy this product, I'd like to be able to pop up something and say, hey, this might be a better product for you. So as an example, if you remember those candy dots on paper,
Sure.
We get almost all, if not all, of the ones that are bad. So the ones that come out, bad dots, they come out either a little bit longer than they should, or the color's wrong or whatever. We call them bloopers. Well, we're able to sell those a lot cheaper, and customers appreciate that because they taste exactly the same. I'm thinking, wouldn't it be nice if I could, when you're on the candy buttons page, it said, hey, would you like to try these bloopers? They're just the same and they cost you half as much.
I'm looking forward to seeing the long-term results of Justuno on conversion rates and email signups. But now that we've fixed a lot of bulk candy stores' problems, our next video that you can click here to view, we're going to work on new functionality that Ken's wanted for a long time, subscriptions. Don't forget to go to ecommercemakeover.com for our playbook and special offers on the tools we're using, and subscribe to be notified when we release new episodes.